Good afternoon. Guys, I want your attention here. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
Thank you. I'll request you guys to please take a notebook because we are going to do something a little where we start to do a little bit of work ourselves. Last week we were looking at projects as having costs and also resources and time. Okay. So here we are going to now look at what I am going to call as the critical path. Okay, so let us see what this critical path is with a simple example. We'll take a very simple example and do it. So I'm going to say that I'm going to have a start of the entire work. So we are going to start. Second thing is, this project, what we are going to do is a very simple, what we'll call as the watchman shed which we have, or the guardhouse which we have opposite. Okay, either we'll do the water tank or we'll do the guardhouse. Okay, now what happens is, in I think we gave you the first problem as excavation of a water tank, right? Okay, so those of you who have managed to go to the cube block, you would have seen a water tank, and it's in a very nice stage. Okay, where you can understand how the water tank actually looks like. Okay, so I'm as usual, we are going to identify the tasks which we have. We are going to have excavation. We need to dig a pit for it. Okay, then we need to do the slope protection work if it's required. Okay, but then let's assume that we don't need to do slope protection work in this case. The next thing which we go about is, we go for PCC, okay, we go for the shuttering for RCC. For PCC, there are two things which happen. There are two things which happen when you do PCC. You will make a excavation for a foundation slightly bigger than the actual foundation, depending on the amount of working space which you require. It will be cheaper for you to do the PCC for the entire mass ground which you have excavated. Okay, so typically you don't do shuttering for PCC in certain cases, but if you go for the new architecture block, you will be able to see shuttering being done for PCC also. Okay, so please remember that it's a case to case basis that we work on. Here we are having the shuttering for RCC, it is mandatory, and then we need to mark columns, we need to mark the columns. So what is this operation? We'll take the drawing, study the location where the columns are coming, and then we'll do the marking. Okay, probably in the next class, I will make it into a presentation. All the steps which I'm talking about, where we're talking about marking and all that, I've got photographs. I will put it in, it's still in my phone. So let me copy it, transfer it, and then I'll show it to you. So you need to mark the columns, then you have to cut and bend reinforcement. Okay, you have to cut and bend reinforcement. Now after this, you go for placing reinforcement. So REIFF, take it as reinforcement. You have to place the reinforcement, then in fact only after this the shuttering operation will come. So you place the reinforcement, do the shuttering, and then you will go for concreting. Okay, you'll go for concreting, de-shuttering, curing. I'm going to give you an exercise. There is a code book called IS 456. IS 456 is the standard we follow to understand how various things are done. So it is telling when I can remove the shuttering from beams, from columns, from slabs, from you name it, all the elements which you are concerned about. Another thing is, you will also look at props. What's a prop? The shuttering is that actual sheet which is kept under the concrete which makes the box. After you remove the shutter, you need to replace the props. Okay, so I'll come back to some of the ways by which you can optimize your project a little later. But for now, your learning is the soffit needs to be supported by props at least, but you can remove the shuttering material. Okay, now I can say that start of work takes 0 days, excavation probably takes 3 days, PCC takes 1 day. Then this shuttering operation is wrongly sequenced. Okay, I cannot do it just here, but let me make it that shuttering for RCC involves cutting the wooden pieces to the required shape. So carpentry work is also involved, plus going and placing it in correct position. So this we can say it takes 2 days, and marking of column, let us put it as 1 day for now, and cutting and bending of reinforcement. Before I cut and bend reinforcement, I have to procure reinforcement. Okay, so I'm going to add one more activity, 12, procure reinforcement. Okay, and this I'm saying it takes, the procurement process takes 4 days. Okay, I have to place the order. The order has to be accepted. Material has to be taken from the godown, brought to the construction site. So procuring takes 4 days. Okay, now cutting and bending of reinforcement, let's say for this project it takes 2 days and placing takes 3 days. Okay, then shuttering is going to take another 2 days, concreting will be 1 day. Okay, and de-shuttering takes 1 day, curing has to be done for 14 days. Okay, so this is the sequence of work which we've got. This is the sequence of work which we have got. Now we are going to do one more thing. We are going to say who is going to come before whom. We are going to say who is going to come before whom. Any activity before start? Nothing. So no activity before start. I am just going to say, call this as predecessor. Okay, and this is the duration. Okay, now what we are having is before start there is no predecessor, so I'm just putting it as a blank. Okay, now excavation can only happen after project has started. Typically if you take a project, you'll need to remove all the shrubs, you have to remove all the undulations till a rough grade is got. That step I have not marked here. Okay, just to keep some of the steps in control. But then when you say excavation is for 3 days, it should involve all these activities. So first thing I do, I make the excavation. After that the PCC comes. So PCC will follow 2. Now what I can do is, I got something, this procuring of reinforcement. Procurement of reinforcement can start after first day, after operation 1. The person has told, yes, you are going to do the job. He's given you the letter of intent. So you can start your procurement activity. So that is one. After I finish procurement of reinforcement only, I can do my cutting and bending. Okay. So cutting and bending can happen only after activity number 12 is done. So here I go. I'm going to mark this as 12. Okay. Now placing of reinforcement can happen only after activity 6 has happened, and shuttering for RCC, I got 2 days here. I am going to say that this is the duration where I am going to cut the reinforcement to size and do all my work. Okay, so I am going to cut the reinforcement, do all the things over here. So this is going to be after activity number 1, and shuttering can only happen after activity 4 is complete as well as activity 7 is complete. You will put the reinforcement, then do the box around it, right? So that is why 2 activities precede shuttering. 2 activities are preceding shuttering, and probably marking of columns cannot happen before PCC is done. So this will be after activity number 3, and placing of reinforcement will be 5,6. Placing of reinforcement will be 5,6. I need to mark it, then only I can be going and putting it in place, right? Now concreting can happen after shuttering, so this I can just put it as 8. Okay, deshuttering can happen after 9, but I can say that with a lag of about a week. Okay, actually it doesn't take a week, about I can do it in a few hours itself. Okay, so I'm just putting it as after 9. Okay, after that day 9, I can do, after the activity 9, I can remove it, because concrete for vertical walls you can move after a few hours. Okay, now after that curing will start immediately after deshuttering, but it goes for 14 days. Is this okay with all of you? Right? Okay. Now I have got almost all the things, and now I'm going to put it in a particular format. This is called precedence diagramming. So in precedence diagramming, you put a box like this and you define the activity in the middle. So I just call this a start with number 1. Okay, then I put a few more things. This is the EST, or the early start time. Early start time is the earliest that an activity can, or a task can start. EST is the earliest when a task can start. You cannot do it before a particular time. Okay, so that is EST. Okay, so after that I'm going to put the duration. I'm going to put the duration over here. Okay, I'm going to put the duration over here. Then I'm going to have the early finish time over here. I'm going to have the early finish time over here. Then the other two things are LST, or late start time, and late finish time. Okay, so suppose we look at a project, we typically go by the calendars. I believe in going by the calendars. Okay, suppose I'm going to start a project, I'm only going to do it with a calendar. So that is called as the project calendar. What is this project calendar? It tells the time when we can do work, when we are going to be having a day of holiday, or we're going to have a day of rest. Okay, so let us say that the project is starting today. I'm going to take a screenshot of the calendar, but this is a little difficult, it's a little tricky in this. Let me see if I'm having the luck. Snipping tool. Problem is, the moment I give new, it this fellow will go away, this calendar will go away. I think just a minute, let's give a little longer delay, and yeah, I think this should do it. Okay. Okay, let me just look at the calendar. I have no choice, I have to open the calendar every time. Let's say that project starts today, 11th, a nice day because we got 5 working days for us. Okay, so I'm going to start it on 11-9. Early start is 11-9. The duration of start is 0. Okay, it has 0 float, everything is 0. In fact, the problem is, even for a one day activity, I'll be putting it as 11-9 here. So this might be a little tricky to understand. But for now, you take it that if it is a zero duration activity, the next activity will start with the same date. The activity will start with the same date. Okay. Now let us see what is following one. Excavation follows one. Shuttering for RCC follows one. Okay. So quickly we'll do this. Excavation. Excavation and so now what is the duration of excavation? Duration of excavation, 1 day. So I put 1 over here and sorry, 2 days, 3 days. Okay, thank you. So maybe I'll fill the insides with a different color so that it's a little more visible. Now this is 3 days. So the project, according to us, if this is 0, it starts on the same day. So I put 11-9 here. 11th the person is excavating, 12th he is excavating, 13th he is excavating. So 3 days means he finishes it on 13-9. Okay guys, how many days are we going to work in our project? Are we working on Saturdays? No. Thank you. In our site, people are working even on Sundays. Okay, so as project managers, we tend to decide a lot of things. We take Saturday's working day. Okay, so 13-9, it's getting over. Right, now the next one is shuttering. So I get shuttering over here. If I'm making any mistake in the numbering, you please tell me. Okay, it doesn't, not that it matters much, but for consistency's sake, I'd rather have the numbers correct. How many days is shuttering scheduled for? 2 days. So again, I'm going to start on 11-9. When will I finish shuttering? How many days is shuttering? Shuttering for RCC, 2 days. So I start on 11th, how many days does it go? I mean, what would be the calendar date I finish? 12. So I finish this on 12-9. Okay. Now, I got both of these. After this, I look for the thing which precedes 2. That is, PCC is here. So probably, Eleventh I'm working, 12th I'm working, 2 days. Okay. So what I'm doing is I'm just doing a little easy way out. Here after right after shuttering, what is activity number 4? Activity 4 is shuttering for RCC. Array, wait a minute, how did I get shuttering here as 3? This is PCC. Is PCC 2 days? PCC is 1 day. Okay, that means PCC, I am making a change here. 1 day, 11-9 I start, I work the whole day. And then I'm finishing PCC. So that means PCC comes to 11. For 1 minute. Yeah, please. For PCC, the correct, correct. Yes, yes, you're right. Actually, there's one more shuttering for, okay, this is actually preparation of shutter here. Guys, this is preparation for shutter. Okay, so we were right in the first place. This is preparation for shutter. Okay, so let me probably rephrase a little, prepare shuttering. Okay, I prepare shuttering and I think this is 2 days. Okay, preparing shuttering is 2 days, and this is actually 4. Preparing shuttering is activity number 4. And this is 2 days. This is 2 days, and this will become 14, this will become 13, 11, 12. This will become 12. Okay, and now activity number three depends on activity number 2. Activity number 3 depends on activity number 2. And this is PCC. Activity number 3 is PCC. The duration of PCC is 1 day. Okay, the duration of PCC is 1 day. Now, what would be the early start date which I can achieve? What is the early start date which we can achieve? We can start it on 14th. Okay, so I start on 14th. When will I be able to finish this? 14th night. Okay, so now what is the, again, let us go back and make the dependency. Right, so this is the way by which we are flowing across. Okay, now after we have finished, so we have put activity number 1, activity 2, 3, 4. When I come to 5, it depends on 3, which is over here. So let me go. One of the advantages which I have is I can keep moving to the right. If suppose you are not able to move much to the right, I'll suggest you keep a landscape format of your notebook. If you have started on portrait and you don't want to repeat, keep a connector. Put a small circle, put a number or name, say that it's connecting the thing. So it's up to you. So here we go. So here, let me remove all this stuff which is inside. Right. And so we are going to now look at marking columns. So five, mark columns. I'll suggest that you ask doubt here, yeah, please. Okay, right, coming here, marking columns, what is the duration of marking columns? How long do we mark columns? 1 day. Okay, now with the theodolite and theodolite gone, total station in place, marking columns becomes very easy. And so it can start on 15-9 and gets over on the same day, 15-9. Okay, now we have finished also activity number 5. Anything depends on 5. So here we see that placing reinforcement depends on 5 and 6. Okay, placing reinforcement depends on 5 and 6. And anything depending on 4. Yeah, here it is. Shuttering depends on 3. Shuttering depends on 3 and 7. So I need to be a little smart when I do this. So I got marking of columns done. After I mark the columns, what depends on 5? It depends on 5 and 6 over here. Okay, I got item number 12 procure reinforcement, I have completely forgotten. I conveniently forgotten procuring reinforcement. Okay, I have completely forgotten procuring reinforcement. So what I'll do, I will add procuring reinforcement over here. Okay, I'm adding procuring reinforcement over here. So this is item number 12, procure rebar. It only depends on this one. I can start on 11-9. I think it's 4 days. 11, 12, 13, 14. So 14-9 this gets over. Okay. Any other fellows depending on this? Who depends? 12. Item number 6 depends on this. Item number 6 depends on this. So item number 6 is depending on this and anything else? Yeah, item number 6 depends only on 12. So I can bring item number 6 over here. I make cutting reinforcement over here. How many days do I take for that? 2 days. So that means now this is the place where you have to get a little smart. Okay, now we are having 14 over here. Now look at this calendar. 14th is a Thursday, and I start on 15th this work. I still am lucky. 15-9, I can finish this on 16-9. So we are safe. But then, what is happening is, have a look at this. What happens after 6th? Now, I've managed to take, I've accounted for procuring reinforcement. I've accounted for cutting and bending. Next, placing of reinforcement depends on 5 and 6. So here, 5 is over here, 6 is over here. I can keep this here itself, or I can move this slightly like this so that it looks a little neater. And okay, so this is going to be our item number 7. What is our item number 7? Placing the reinforcement. Now, when can placing of reinforcement start? This is the trick here. Now look here, 17th is a Sunday. I have to have both the activities leading to this completed before I can start. I have to finish both the activities leading to this before I can start. Both marking columns have to be done and cutting of reinforcement has to be done before I can place my reinforcement, right? So now I look at the calendar. Marking column is finished, so 16th I could start. But then I come here, I come to cutting of reinforcement, I see that 16th is there. So I have to definitely ensure that this work is complete. So I have to take 16th as the base value. Now I look at the calendar, 17th happens to be a holiday. So I have to start placing reinforcement on 18th. Okay. How many days does it take to place the reinforcement? How many days? 3 days. Okay. So placing reinforcement takes 3 days. 18, 19, 20. Now in the calendar, I can define 20th as a holiday. Okay, for some reason. Say Rivera is coming, right? So Rivera is coming, so no work. I'm sorry, Gravitas is coming, no work. So we could do that. But as of now, I'm not doing it. Here, just the way you treated Sunday, you're going to treat the rest of the days. Okay. So 18, 19, 20. So 29 is the earliest I can finish the work. Okay. Right. Now I am again coming to my list. So I finished placing reinforcement. Look at shuttering. Shuttering depends on two things, item number 4 plus item number 7. So it depends on two things. Item number 8. So where is item number 4? Actually, I think this is item number 4. I am removing this fellow. And keeping my box over here. So this is item number 8. Item number 8 depends on 7. As well as item number 4. Okay, so now which date can this fellow start? On which date can shuttering actually start? Placing shutter start? 21. And how many days? So let me again check with the calendar. Starts on 21. 21, 22 is no problem. So 21, 9, 2 days, it gets over on 22. 9. It's over on 22, 9. Okay. Now I have finished also activity number 8. The rest of the stuff is linear. Rest of the stuff is linear. One after the other only they are coming. Okay. So one, two, three, and I'm also going to go for another one, stop or end. Okay, so what is activity number 9? Concreting. Item number 10 is curing, I guess, or deshuttering. And activity number 11 is curing. And activity number 12 is stop. Oh, sorry. Activity number 13 is stop. Thank you. Activity number 13 has to be stopped because 12 you have given procurement of reinforcement. Okay. So how many days does concreting take place? One day. So 22, 23, I think it's over. So I start on 23. I finish on 23. Okay. Deshuttering takes one day. Now the problem comes here. 24th is a Sunday. Am I going to deshutter on Sunday or not? I can leave shuttering on that date. It's not going to matter. So I can do it on 24th without any issue. Come. You took him to the. Huh? You have enough money? Yes. Okay, so actually 24th, I can't start on 24th, I have to start on 25th. So here I go, I change it to 25. Curing again starts on 26-9. It goes for 14 days. Okay. Now, here there is something which we need to think. Curing is a continuous operation. 14 days I have said curing has to be done, but I got holidays in the middle. what are we going to do? Okay. So, in practice, we will give a different working calendar for curing. For that activity curing alone, we will give a different calendar. But now what I'm doing is, I'm just going to make 14 with the holidays. Okay, I'm going to make it with the holidays. In the next exercise, we will see how we can account for this one, for holidays. Because of various reasons, mainly because it's a pain in the neck. Okay, it's a pain in the neck. So can you just tell me on which date, if I start on 20, take out your calculators and your mobile phones, they got calendars. Calculate the day curing can get completed, assuming that we are having Saturdays as holidays. I mean Sundays as holidays. Take your calendar and give me the date. Quickly, quickly. October. Okay, thank you. So 11th of October is the date my work gets finished. 11th October it gets finished. Now we are going to do what is called as a, see what we have done now is a forward pass. Okay, what has been done now is a forward pass. We will now do a backward pass. What is this backward pass? We are going to go backward some of the times. Now we found at which point in time I could start the work earliest. I have to wait for all the preceding activities to get completed before I can start my work. So now I am going to see how late I can start the work. There is no way I can play around here. So 11, 10 etc. remains the same. Now here again I start on 11, 10. I backwork 14 days. I backwork 14 days. It is 26.9. Okay. Now, late start minus early start, number of days is called as the float. For now, you just take it as a formula. Float is the amount of free time which you have. For these activities, there is no free time. When you go to the earlier activities, you'll see how the free time is coming. So now, de-shuttering again, 26. One day before that is 25.9 minus 25.9 0. This is the float. Okay, this column is the float or slack or the free time which we have. Okay, so this is 25.9. Again, I come here. Sunday is there, so I go for 23.9 0 23.9. These places don't have much fun, guys. Any doubt in this backward pass? How we are doing? What we are trying to do is, we are trying to see how late I can start the work now. First, earliest we can start and earliest we can finish. How late I can start, how late I can finish without affecting the deadline. Without affecting the deadline. Okay. So then, here again this is 23.9, 21.9. Now here comes a branch. Okay. I find that I can start this on 29, again 0. 18.9. But let's go to this branch and see. I can start this on 29. I can start this on 29 and still not get affected on the schedule. Okay. If I start it even on, if I finish it on 20th of September, preparing or shuttering, I will still ensure that my project is in time. Okay. So now, let's see how many days is available from 29 till 12.9. So 20, it's here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. So this will become 19.9. I know, yeah. Let's just take a 10 minutes here. Because anyway, if it had been a lab class, it would have had only half an hour. So come on. Please wait for, you're not babies, okay? Which start to cry. You know that 1 year old, 1 month old or 1 day old, The moment it gets hungry, only thing it knows is to cry. This is from my experience I'm saying. Okay, I assume that you are all responsible adults in this class. So, I'm sure you can wait for that 10 minutes. Right. Now come here. You are going to see that you are having quite a lot of days. You are having about 7 days which you are having between these 2 days. Okay. Between 29, okay, between 29 and 11-9 or 12-9, I am having one working, one holiday. So this makes it, I got a float of 8 days. I got a float of 8 days. 12th to 20th, I can delay the work by 8 days without affecting the overall project schedule. Okay, so this is the beauty of what we have. Now come here. What happens over here? This 18, again, we are having this problem of Sunday. So this is 16-9. Same thing happens here, 16-9. Okay, because of this, we are going to get 1 day's float over here. We are going to get a 1 day float over here. The same thing will continue over here when I take 15-9. Okay, so on and so forth. When I come here right till this point, I am having a free time of 1 day. Okay, and in all of these activities, I am not going to be able to delay even by a single, I don't have any chance of delaying these activities. Okay, now when I come here, the latest I can finish is from this time, 11-9 I put here, and then I put this as again 11-9. Okay, of course start doesn't have any float, so this is how we go about backworking the problem. What we have done, we have done two things. We saw how early each activity has to start, then we pushed it backward. We see how late I can start an activity. There's only one place, there's one loop which is having free float of 1 day throughout. Okay, that means I can delay excavation by 1 day, but still I will not affect the project schedule. Okay, I'll still not affect the project schedule. So here what happens, for preparing shuttering, a lot of delay is there. It means that instead of starting on 11-9, I will try to start on 19-9. What is the benefit of starting on 19-9? I will engage my carpenter on 19th and keep him continuously till the box is made. Okay, so this is how, and tool like this helps us to understand projects. Okay, how the project works. Okay, do you have any doubt in what we have seen till now? It's very straightforward. This is being made into a video which I'll upload as soon as possible. Okay, so you please follow this. I have got a couple of other videos which I have done, which are for one was for a mechanical engineering group and for another group which was doing civil engineering. Okay, so you will get different viewpoints by studying these, going through these videos. So we will have a very short test on this. You want to do it in class or in hostel? Okay, we'll do it in class. Okay, we will do it on Thursday. Okay, we'll do this on Thursday. In the next class, on that's tomorrow's class, I will very quickly put this in MS Project and show it to you. Okay, to help you relate how this calculation is coming. After this, everything will be only done in MS Project. Okay, now this is the path which has only zero float is called as the critical path. The path which is having zero float is called as the critical path. Okay, so that we should not delay any activity on that route. All the activities have to be done in time on that particular path. We have, so the critical path method is common for the other one also. PERT they call it, In PERT, the only difference is the way you estimate time. Okay, so PERT estimates time differently, but all the other steps remain the same. Please remember, in my course, we will be only using a calendar. Okay, I don't know which is the textbook which follows a calendar system. There will be textbooks, but I have not come across it. But in all my career, I have never had a project which I go by the way they give it in the textbook, like 0 days, blah, blah, blah. That doesn't work in a construction project site. Okay, so if you have any doubts, please feel free to ask. This video also will be uploaded as soon as possible so that you are having the resource on Thursday. Okay, so thank you very much. Thank you for your patience. We will meet again tomorrow. Right?